strengths? What are your weaknesses? What do you like about yourself? What do you dislike about yourself? While answering such questions, we disclose some facts and some thoughts we keep within ourselves. Now, how do you determine the strengths and weaknesses we have, or the good and imperfect features we possess? Where did these beliefs come from? A judgmental teacher? A circle of friends? Parents, relatives, siblings, caretakers who label you a certain way? Or maybe from yourself? Each person has a self-image, a mental blueprint that describes the kind of person they are. This all-important preconception of about yourself holds the belief you hold about yourself based on past experiences, successes or failures. Some of these are positive and some are detrimental to moving ahead and making change. It's not about success or failure all the time. It's about how we feel about ourselves. I didn't like my nose. I was really nosy about my nose. I don't remember the chain of events that resulted in this dislike. But I did not like my nose. So never did I face any problem related to breathing or smelling. I mean, that's what a nose is expected to be. When I was expecting my first child, my main concern was the baby should not inherit my nose. Again, I don't know when I found out that our noses are similar, because it never really mattered. She filled me up with enormous joy and will be the most beautiful person I've ever seen. So today, now that our noses are similar, I'm in love with my nose and would love to have this nose of mine in my coming days. So you see, it's all in the mind. Whenever I hear the word mind, I remember the phrase, mind is a mountain. There's an interesting experiment done to analyze the process of behavioral conditioning in a zoo. In a zoo, there were 5 monkeys in a cage. One day, a banana was hung from the ceiling and a ladder kept underneath it so that the banana could be reached by climbing up the ladder. Seeing this, one of the monkeys tried to get the banana. Just when it was about to take it, cold water was sprayed on all the monkeys with a hose by the zoo attendants. Naturally, the monkey ran down and all of them were howling and growling. After some time, another monkey tried, but received the same water spray. So after two attempts, all of them decided not to go for it. The banana was replaced the next day, but none of them even looked at it, knowing very well the aftermath of trying to get it. After a few days, one of the monkeys was replaced with a new one. This new monkey was surprised as to why the others are not going to take the banana. So he climbed up the ladder, and just when he was about to take it, all the other monkeys came running and get the hell out of this monkey. This monkey was shocked and could not fathom the reason why he was being bitten. He did not know the past and was ignorant of the fact that these monkeys were anticipating the same water spray. He tried a couple of more times, but he received the same result. Eventually, he stopped. Again, after some days, another old monkey was replaced with a new one. So now, there were 3 old monkeys and 2 new ones. The newer one got tempted. Well, he was bitten up back. But the surprising thing was that the monkey who came just earlier also took part in the mission, without even knowing why the beating was taking place. Could be that, since he was bitten, this was the easiest way to get even. Slowly, all the older monkeys were replaced, and now the cage housed 5 new monkeys, and none of them were ever sprayed with cold water. But the surprising fact is that none of them even tried to get the banana, and if anyone tried, he was bitten up by the rest. Interesting, right? Now look closer, around you. You'll find that we all do similar stuff every day. Doing things just because someone asked us to do it or someone else is doing it, without even questioning the logic or the reason. This is conditioning, and we all are products of the conditioning that we receive. I studied in a convent school, and right from the beginning, we were told to talk softly. And you know what happened? 2 weeks back, I delivered my ice paper speech, and I was not audible to all. Leave aside content and everything else, the very basic fact was missing. I can love, my husband can vouch for that. I felt so bad that I decided, even if any toastmaster get deafened, I will shout my heart out. So it's for us to decide whether we'll continue monkeying around or free ourselves from the cage of condition. People experience both positive and negative beliefs about themselves that hypnotize them in similar ways, and the goal is therefore to overcome the irrational thoughts that hold us behind. To do so, we only need to harness the power of rational thinking. Our negative beliefs aren't the result of facts or experience, rather, the conclusions that we draw from them. Rational thinking, which is logical and conscious, can be used to control the unconscious mind. To start uprooting the beliefs that hold you back, that create your sense of inferiority, ask yourself why. Doing so will help you overcome the irrational and false assumptions like, I failed yesterday, so I'll fail today. Instead, when faced with rational thinking, you recollect your memories from the failure, the learnings from the failure, and understand that each day presents an opportunity to learn from the failures. Our success and failure are the result of forces buried deep within our personality. So take out your editing pen. It's time to make some changes. What do you say, Mr. Goswami?